Old man's about to get real. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Fresh, and we are back where we left off. Like I said, we're gonna keep this thing rolling straight throughout. I'm gonna go through side missions, main story, errands, hunting trials, pretty much everything. At least I'm gonna try to get everything on footage. There might be like one cauldron I think I wasn't able to record, but I think for the most part I have just about everything, besides the beginning. Unfortunately, something happened with my data. It was tragic. But happy New Year's to everybody who may or may not be watching this around when this first get posted. Hope everybody's having a wonderful new year, start to the new year. Hope you all being safe and that we can all have a prosperous new 2023. So, kind of like I stated in another video, I won't be doing too much talking, just kind of doing some play-by-play commentary here and there. Right now, man, with this battle, it wasn't too much of a challenge, but for whatever reason, those shots was not landing initially, unless it was doing a lot of base damage, and I didn't realize it, because his health bar is fairly low, but I feel like it could at least maybe show more of the static damage. And that was kind of crazy too. Him just going through that big boulder right there to hit me. Trash. But I shall prevail. Boom, 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 boom. Oh yeah, I see the big damage. Oh yeah.
He's dead. Finally.
Also, for anybody who does take the time to watch this video or any of my videos, put in the comment section, like, how do you guys feel about like live streaming and things of that nature? I'm gonna be doing it off of my console, my PS5 console, in the HD camera, so hopefully that works out well. We'll see what the quality looks like, and I'll go from there. Don't really have a whole streaming setup and rig and whatnot. I might get there eventually. We'll see how far we can grow my community here on YouTube. Just having fun playing this. Give me the loot. Definitely gonna be looting.
Once I get the backup, I can reboot Gaia, fix the system, heal the Blight, restore Elizabeth's dream. But is it still there? Okay. I should find the server room. It's here.
Gaia version 6.9. Initializing. Hello.
Hi. Lisbeth? Travis Tate.
Now, what's this we got here? A Farzine's conspiracy to steal a copy of Gaia? And her subordinate functions? Naughty, naughty. You want me to handle this, Liz?
Boom. So tragic. Imagine getting to what you think is gonna be your finish line or the break in that storm, and it's like, boom. Nope. It's still going. Very unfortunate. But, you know, that's life. It goes like that.
Aloy?
The goddess.
There is no goddess. I told you that already. That's not Gaia. It's not what I'm looking for. It's nothing but a fake.
Ugh.
I got it.
Varl, I'm sorry.
You have a sharp bite sometimes, you know? But it was pretty amazing to see you fly off that tower and blow up the entire basin.
The thing is, there's going to be more of that. I'm out of leads, Varl. But I have to keep searching. And fast, and whatever risks I have to take, I will. And it doesn't make sense to have someone with me. Someone who might get hurt. This is on me, Varl. Nobody else.
Hold on. Before, in Meridian, you said there was a man who helped you. Silence. You said you used to talk to him a lot about things you discovered from the old world, things no one else understands. And he gave you the lance you used to defeat Hades.
He's gone, Varl. I haven't heard from him since the battle against Hades.
Sure, but Spymaster Murad back in Meridian, he's good at finding people, isn't he?
Varl,
Come on, it might work. Plus, you'll get to see some friendly faces again.
Okay. I guess it's worth a shot.
We've got a long walk ahead.
Actually, I've got a better idea.
Son, it's true. She's come back.
Bless us. The savior of Meridian has returned.
You earned this welcome. You saved them.
Not yet.
In the name of the Sun King of Vard, a royal welcome for the champion.
Make way.
Murad. Aloy has an urgent matter to discuss.
Dashane, that makes two of us. I've sent forth hunters for weeks. To Sunfall, all the way to the Sacred Land, searching for you. Something happened at the Spire. Come. I'll show you.
Watch your step. You saved us all, to be sure, but, we're still cleaning up the mess.
I notice there's a lot of cutscenes at the beginning here of the game. How do you guys feel about that?
We were able to explain it away, thank the
story. All right so far. I mean, gives you a little bit of, I guess, backstory and also kind of also confirms and/or helps my argument of it being more so of like a movie or a series if you watch out the gameplay and just playing it honestly.
From Meridian it looked like a trick of the lights, but those who were closer atop the light said it could not have been a reflection. Much to my dismay, they said the light rose up from the tower's base. From that, we left everything just as it was.
What do you think happened?
I don't know. The Spire's supposed to send out signals, messages, for the terraforming system.
But Hades tried to use it to wake up ancient war machines.
I was sure I cut the connection to that thing. Wait here while I check it out.
Let us know what you find.
Looks the same as before. I could pull this thing out of my mouth. What? Check transmission. Something was transmitted from the top of the spire. I guess I have to find a way up there. I guess I should be flattered by the statue. It feels wrong. Especially when my job's only half done.
You always look so grumpy.
If you hear a scraping.
Bit busy now, but we'll talk soon.
We said the West would be dangerous, but
wait till we get to the next Dell.
I got nothing to tell you.
Keep your eyes open for the metal parts and the debris.
Looks like a memorial. Honoring those who fell in the Battle of the Alight. Lots of brave people defended this place from Hades. Machine carcasses. Remnants from the Battle of the Alight. We were almost overrun by the machines Hades controlled. We pushed through.
Walk it up, huh?
Yeah, you!
Savior, I hope all is well with you.
Hey, I thought you'd left by now. Not again.
Deeply honored, Savior. Those who fought at the Battle of the Alight will never forget what you did.
Didn't expect to see you up and about.
Good to see you back here, Savior. Meridian owes you a debt it can never repay, Savior.
There's Meridian. Still standing, despite the battle against Hades and the Eclipse. Scaffolding at the base of the spire.
Savior, the orb remains untouched, as per Blameless Murad's instructions. Savior, I'm relieved to see you in good health.
Maybe I can jump to that ledge behind me. cross over to the spire. Looks like I can use my pull caster on that. Should be able to get up there now. I thought Silence was helping me when he gave me his lance. It looks like he tricked me. He transmitted something through the spire. Did he save Hades? Why would he do that? Well, if I can figure out where he sent it, I can track him down. Hopefully the transmission node at the top will tell me. Well, doesn't look like I can keep climbing this way.
Well, Aloy, I see you finally figured it out. To be honest, I'm surprised it took you so long to discover my rules.
You rigged the lance to steal Hades. How could you be so reckless?
Reckless? You're the one who tried to purge Hades before its precious knowledge could be extracted. The mysterious signal that woke it, for example. But why not obtain one of those Gaia backups you've been having such a hard time finding?
If you knew, why didn't you just tell me?
I've been having problems of my own these past 6 months, Aloy. The difference is, I've made progress. So once your anger at my entirely necessary deception has faded, then why don't you come out here and find me in the Forbidden West and learn all that I've discovered?
Oh, I'll come find you.
Yes. Well, and the coordinates make it simple enough. Even for you.
I feel like they didn't really have to make Silas a big douche unless he's gonna end up being a ultimately terrible person here at the end of the game. I guess we'll see once we get to the end. Well, depending on how this one ends, might be a third one coming up. But, yeah, I don't know. Because instead of him making smart, snarky remarks and whatnot, and trying to be a step ahead and whatnot, I would be in the dark if he wasn't hiding details in the truth. So, I mean, maybe that's just the point of it, but that part's a little annoying in my opinion.
You went inside it, and it transformed, almost like the day of the battle.
I can only be grateful that it's a stormy day. Few will have seen the tower change from Meridian. What did you discover?
Hades. The danger didn't end here. It went into the Forbidden West. And I have to follow.
I see. That can be difficult. The West is called Forbidden for a reason. A tribe of ferocious warriors controls much of it. The Tanakh,
and they allow no trespassers past its border. That's it. Under the Sun King of Art, a fragile peace has been negotiated. And indeed, the next embassy will take place in a day or two on the edge of the frontier. Were you to attend the gathering under his auspices, the Tanakh might grant right of passage instead of hunting you and attacking on sight.
Great, just what I need. More killers.
The Sun King.
Aloy, it's good to see you. You left in such haste. We never had a chance to properly thank you.
Can we show the champion the spear now, please?
Itamin, quiet.
It's true. We bear gifts. Decorum usually calls for a ceremony of offering at the palace. But I thought you would prefer a less formal occasion. Bring them, please.
Avad, this is all very kind, but I... Who's it? Vanasha.
Quick. Better hand them over before she runs off again.
Really? Must you?
Try it on.
It's beautiful.
On behalf of all the citizens of the Sundom, may these tokens remind you of our eternal gratitude.
Perhaps you'd like to spend more time with your friends. Come speak to me when you're ready to depart.
I need to attach the Master Override to my new spear. Should be a workbench around here I can use. Dowager Queen Nasadi.
Blessed champion. Itamin, what do you say?
My humblest thanks to you, great champion, for delivering my mother and me from Sunfall, and for defending our holy city against the forces of Shadow. Did I say it right?
You said it fine, Itamin. And you're welcome.
Champion, will you teach me how to shoot like a real machine hunter?
Itamin.
I have to go on an important mission, Prince.
To save the world?
Something like that. But when I come back, I could give you a few tips. It would be an honor.
We owe you our lives, champion. And we will not forget. May the sun light your way.
Watch out for Thunderjaws, champion!
Part of the Deathbringer we defeated. This machine was the last line of defense for Hades. It dragged the orb up here and then nearly killed me, but... It's just a piece of scrap now.
Huh?
meantime, Tosserum laborers have been hired to speed up reconstruction. Very good.
Everything's just the way you left it.
There. The workbench.
What is this, Vinasha? The silent treatment?
Okay. Master override installed. Plus, something new. To store up and release energy. Resonator. Should help in a fight.
Come to think of it, what happened to that hammer you lost?
It'll be fine. No.
Uthid. Vinasha. Thanks.
Now, is it me or is it that I think it was this woman right here. It might have been another woman that was like wearing Shadow Carja gear. But one of them were flirting with Aloy really heavy. I feel like it was this one, but she kind of just gives off flirtatious vibes for no reason. But maybe that's just supposed to be her type of character. I don't know. Anybody else catch those vibes, or is that just me?
Always.
You both look like you're doing well.
Mr. Shiny Pants here is now the Sun King's senior military advisor. That means people actually have to listen to him talk. May the sun bless their sorry souls.
At least I say something of substance every once in a while.
What was that? I just fell asleep while you were talking.
And how about you, Vinasha?
I've been looking after Nasadi and Edaman, two parts bodyguard, one part...
Bad influence.
Huh. I was gonna say nanny, but I like your version better.
I never pictured you as a nanny. Edaman must be special.
Hold on now. I'm not entirely domesticated. Nasadi was the Mad Sun King's wife. She has enemies. I've had to foil a plot or two.
Right. You can try to hide it, but inside, you're as soft as a silk pillow.
Oh, you have no idea.
Huh? Oh, dear.
We were talking about Edaman?
Yeah. Okay, I admit it. Edaman's cute. He's fun. And he looks up to me. I like him. Except when he forgets to wash his hands after hooking worms in that muddy garden behind a solarium. Blech.
It's been months since I was in Sunfall. What's become of the Shadow Carja?
After you wiped out the Eclipse, there were hardly any priests or officers left to terrorize the little people.
Avad offered amnesty to all who were forced to serve the Shadow. So the commoners cleaned out the Citadel and handed it back to him. The Sundom was unified.
Avad wanted Uthid to take command of the garrison there, but Captain Cuddly here refused. Rumor has it that he wanted to stay close to me here in Meridian.
That's nonsense, of course.
Huh.
Well, I know. You're out. Go! Away with you.
Always an honor, champion.
Always a pleasure. But please, little Huntress, come back someday and tell us about your adventures. If I can't get in trouble, at least I can hear about yours.
The sculptor wanted something even bigger, twice the size, covered in gold and jewels. But I was quite certain you wouldn't appreciate that.
You were right. I'm sorry, Avad. It's good to see you, but I can't stay long.
I see. I'd hoped you'd remain in the city for a time. Perhaps at the palace.
Meridian's still in danger. But it's bigger than that. To put things right, I have to go west. To Nocth territory.
By the sun, that's a Nocth? Well, perhaps Murad already told you, but after years of hostility, we've negotiated a truce. In hopes of a lasting peace. Another embassy will be held in just a day or two.
When you say years of hostility, I assume you mean the Red Raids?
Ah, yes. My favorite subject.
I wouldn't ask if I didn't need to know.
As you know, my father raided all the border tribes. The Oseram, Banuk, and Nora suffered greatly, resisting as best they could. But none fought back like the Tanakh. They rose up and assaulted our western front at Barren Light, sweeping us from their lands. Getting them to talk to us again after that was tricky.
How did you get the Tanakh to talk again after the war?
The same way I got you to talk. By giving gifts.
The Tanakh like tiaras?
More like medals, spices, and relics looted during the fighting. We've met with them on several occasions. And the gifts seem to have eased the tension. But this coming embassy is the most important yet. The best sign we've had so far that the Tanakh want lasting peace.
What makes this coming embassy so special?
Well, just like today, it is special because of the guest. Our delegation will meet with the Tanakh just outside Barren Light. We'll give them treasure, and they'll return a prisoner. Fashav, one of our finest soldiers.
Soldier? Don't you mean raider?
No. Not in this case. Fashav is my cousin. Nothing like Helis and his ilk. He joined the Western Expedition with the hopes of reining in certain excesses. But he was captured during a heroic defense of our forward base at Cinnabar Sands. And has been held ever since.
Your cousin, Fashav. How long has he been a Tanakh captive?
5 years. Tanakh emissaries swear he is well, but I wonder. That tribe is renowned for its brutality. How did he survive? Well, I'll know soon enough. If you see him before I do, tell him that I await him in Meridian. Where he belongs.
If I see him, I will. Edelman looks happy.
And you got him out of Sunfall. Any happiness he has, he owes to you. He's turning into a fine young man. Which he'll need to be if he's to inherit the crown.
Wouldn't the crown go to a son of yours first?
Yes, well, I'd have to get married for that to happen. Murad keeps throwing noble matches at me. But I find I'm always trying to make them into someone they're not. At any rate, I never aspired to the throne, and I don't wish to sit there forever. When Edelman comes of age, I hope to step aside. Free of the crown, I might finally be able to travel the world. Who knows? Perhaps even accompany you on one of your adventures.
You make it sound easy. I need to get going.
One moment, Aloy. There's something I must ask you. Since you left, I've thought of little else.
This isn't really the time.
But it has to be. The way you left before, there's no way to know when I'll see you again. I'm not trying to stop you. Or hold you back. But I need to know. When your mission is over, will you return to Meridian? And stay? Long enough for us to spend time to get to know each other properly, perhaps.
I do hope to see Meridian again, Avat. And you. But this mission, it's my life. It's all I can think about. I have to stay focused. What happens after? I can't imagine that. I wouldn't know where to begin.
Well, if that place were to end up being Meridian, know that you will always receive a boundless welcome here. Tend to your mission, Aloy. I will hope for your success. And look forward to your return.
Aloy,
well, that's everyone.
Are you finished with your friends, or
nice
do you need more time?
A little while. I better get going. And if I'm headed west, it sounds like I'll need rite of passage from the Tanakh, as you said. Where exactly is this embassy going to be held?
Past the Daunt. The canyon that marks the western border of the Sundom. You'll find the fortress of Baron Light at its farthest edge. The embassy will take place just beyond its gates. It's a long march, a fortnight on foot.
A couple of days hard riding should get us there.
Actually, it might be better to rest here tonight. Head out in the morning.
Of course. I'll arrange it.
Thank you. all their kindness calls to me. I have to block it out. My voice has grown so somber. These words don't seem like mine, but the iron won't subside. No matter what I try.
Like, look at this beautiful cutscene. And basically just a credit scene. Just absolutely lovely. It's like a robotic Red Dead Redemption type of feel right here. But again, guys, I greatly appreciate anybody who took the time to watch the video, watch some of the video. Hopefully you guys give me a like, subscribe. I don't know if anybody does sharing anymore, but hey, if you want to share, somebody who's interested in, you know, a Horizon series, definitely send them my way. Like I said, I'm going to be doing the whole game. I have a few more videos to post here. Just gotta, like I said, do a little commentary that I want to. I didn't want to just throw them up with just the footage. I don't know if you guys like that. I guess I could throw some of them up there with just the gameplay throughout. But yeah, so this will be the beginning to the beginning of Into the Forbidden West, Road to the Burning Shores. Thanks, guys. Have a good one. Happy New Year's.